Hi everyone, welcome back. In today's video, we are going to be learning all about nutrition during lactation. What are your caloric requirements? What foods to avoid? And if it's okay to have caffeine or alcohol. So stay tuned to the end of the video so you can learn all you need to know to have the best nutrition during your lactation journey. My name is Kassi Reyes. I am a registered nurse and a board certified lactation consultant and the co-founder of People's Lactation here in Washington, DC. I am so happy you're here and would love it if you consider subscribing down below if you're interested in seeing more videos about lactation. This week's topic comes from a member of our community who posted this question to our Facebook group, Lactation for the People. And I'm so happy that she brought up the topic because I've been meaning to make a video on this for a while. So here we go. So the number one question is, do you need to have a perfectly balanced diet during lactation and in order to produce milk? And the answer to that is no. The human body is designed to provide for a baby even in times of famine. That being said, a balanced diet is definitely recommended, but you don't have to be perfect 100% of the time to be able to have a successful lactation journey. So I usually tell the families I work with that the parent who is lactating should eat the way they usually eat. There are no foods that you absolutely need to avoid during lactation. Whatever you usually eat as part of your balanced diet, your baby is most likely going to tolerate. Unless there are known food allergies in your family, then pay attention to things like, for example, if there's a known nut allergy or cow's milk protein allergy in your family, if every time you eat those foods, your baby has a certain reaction to that, then that might be a time that you would consider eliminating those foods from your diet. Another thing that is recommended to avoid during lactation is fish that are high in mercury. Fish such as tuna, swordfish, shark, any large fish that eat other fish tend to be high in mercury, and it's recommended to avoid those during pregnancy and during lactation. During lactation, you are burning extra calories. So in order to maintain your energy and support a healthy milk supply, you do want to aim for 400 to 500 extra calories per day. And you want to continue having as balanced a diet as possible. So you want to aim for some healthy proteins. This could be in the form of eggs, nuts, beans, and lentils. Chicken, depending on what type of diet you follow. You want to do healthy fats, so nuts, salmon if you eat fish, olive oil, dairy if you eat dairy, lots of varieties of healthy fruits and vegetables, and whole grains. So for whole grains, things like oatmeal, flaxseed, if you like flaxseed, you can sprinkle that on your yogurt, your cereal, in your oatmeal. Quinoa. Your baby is always going to get the nutrients that they need from your milk. Even if your diet isn't the most balanced, your baby is going to get what they need, but it does put you at risk for malnutrition if you're not getting all the nutrients you need. So it's very common that you will be recommended by your OB or your midwife that you continue to take your prenatal vitamins during lactation, just to make sure that you're replenishing all the nutrients that are going out in your breast milk. I also frequently get asked about eating a vegan diet. If you do follow a vegan diet, you can successfully lactate. The only thing that you want to make sure of is that you are getting all those major vitamins and minerals, and you may need to take an additional B12 supplement, which a lot of vegans are already taking anyway. But if you have any questions, just check in with your provider, and you could always have your B12 levels checked and monitored to make sure that they're adequate for your body's needs. And speaking of vitamins, your baby during lactation may be recommended by the pediatrician that you give the baby vitamin D drops. It's common that babies who are exclusively breast or chest fed do need to take some additional vitamin D. breast milk is about 80% water. So a lot of water is going to be leaving your body during lactation, and it's important to replenish that water so you're not getting dehydrated. The recommendation is to drink to thirst, and I always recommend that parents have a pitcher of water or a bottle of water right next to them while they're breast or chest feeding, because usually during the feeding you will start to feel really thirsty. Another thing that a lot of parents want to know about is whether or not it's okay to have some caffeine or alcohol. Families may think that they need to wean in order to be able to introduce these things back into their lifestyle. A little bit of caffeine and alcohol is okay in moderation. You certainly don't need to wean baby just because you want to have a cup of coffee in the morning, or even 2 cups of coffee during the day, or if you have an occasional glass of wine or an occasional drink. You also don't need to necessarily pump and dump if you have a drink. Alcohol stays in your milk the same amount of time it stays in your bloodstream. So if you're feeling the effects of the alcohol, then it's recommended that you avoid giving baby your milk or putting baby to breast or chest. But if you have a drink directly after a feed, it's probably going to be another 2 to 3 hours before baby eats again, in which case by then the alcohol should be out of your milk and out of your system, and it should be safe to feed your baby. Some people are extra sensitive to the effects of caffeine and alcohol, and it can reduce your supply a little bit, so just pay attention to how your supply reacts. Last but not least, some healthy snack ideas or easy one-handed snack ideas. Almonds, hard-boiled eggs, string cheese, veggies and hummus, sliced fruit, low-sugar granola bars, bananas, smoothies, and yes, the occasional lactation cookie. Another video, I have a video on lactation cookies, and there is a recipe there, but I also talk about the fact that if you like cookies, you should eat cookies, but don't count on lactation cookies 100% just to increase your supply. So in summary, there are very few foods you have to avoid during lactation. You should just continue to eat what you normally eat, what you like to eat, and try to have as balanced of a diet as possible. Make sure you're getting all your vitamins and minerals. Your baby's gonna get what they need, but we wanna replenish what you need. Drink water and fluids to thirst, and a little bit of caffeine and alcohol are okay in moderation. You don't need to wean your baby just because you wanna reintroduce some of these into your diet. I'm going to include a link down below for our survival guide for the first 1 to 5 days of your lactation journey. So feel free to click that link if you think that would be helpful to you. And otherwise, I'm so happy that you found this video. I hope you give it a like, join the community. I do release a new video each week on a lactation specific topic. Look up our group Lactation for the People on Facebook and drop me a note if you think of a video topic that you would like to see me cover in the future. Thanks for stopping by, and I will see you all next week.